For the year says when we we were yet sinners.
Jesus
Christ died for us.
And
through his death, we are redeemed. So we can be called the daughters and sons of God. Let somebody shout hallelujah. It is unfortunate that some of us, or many believers today, don't realize themselves or their status before the Lord. And because of that, they deny themselves of the expected blessings and joy they are supposed to enjoy in Him. But the Lord is reminding us today as His children that we are His beloved. We are His beloved. And for this, let's shout hallelujah. So the love of God for believers provides us with access to enjoying His everlasting love. When we are talking of everlasting love, we are talking about something that has no end. One that is inexhaustible. One that will continue to enjoy day by day, month by month, years as we continue to live. The grace to continue to enjoy the Lord even till eternity, the Lord will grant unto us tonight in the name of Jesus. So from the text of the scripture we have read, God wants us to take note of some facts tonight. That is the divine provision of God's law. Divine provision of God's law. From Jeremiah chapter 1, verse 3 that we read. The Bible says, the Lord appeared to us in the past, saying, I have loved you with an everlasting love. I have drawn you with unfailing kindness. So one of the mysteries of God's love for mankind is that it is a kind of love that is unending. Unlike love of man. Now when men extend love to us, it will only last for a while. Let a little thing transpire. They withdraw the love. But God will never withdraw His love from His children. And we have to know that the love He has for us is one that has been even from the beginning. Ephesians chapter 4, chapter 1, verses 4 and 5 says, for He chose us in Him before the creation of the world to be holy and blameless in His sight, and in love He predestined us for adoption to sonship. Jesus Christ, in accordance with the pleasure and will. It is by His pleasure that He chose us. It is by His pleasure that He adopted us. And so we have to be grateful for this. So the provision of God's love for believers was stated even in the book of Jeremiah we read. It was stated by Prophet Jeremiah since the era of the Israelites in captivity. So the Lord is telling us today that no matter the condition we have, no matter the experience we may be having, the love of God is still there for us to enjoy. In fact, it is that love that has been sustaining us, and we will continue to enjoy it in the name of Jesus. We will continue to enjoy it in Jesus' name. So that verse 3 expresses God's desire and plans for his people. I will quickly consider 5 of it. It says, God's love has been made available for mankind. It is already made. It is not what we work for, or what we are going to apply to work for. It has been made available. And that's what we need to do, is to just tap into that privilege and enjoy the Lord. And the Lord will help us to do it in the name of Jesus. When we say in the book of Romans chapter 5 verse 8, that God demonstrated this for us, that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. While we were awaiting judgment, while we were operating under the wrath of God, Christ volunteered to die for us. So it is a love that has been made already. And all we need to do is to tap into it. Praise you to do, God will grant unto us in Jesus' name. The second thing there in that verse 3
is
that God's love rescues believers from the troubles of the world. He says, I have loved you with an everlasting love. I have drawn you with unfailing kindness. For someone to be drawn, it means that such a person is in a particular place. Maybe the place has not been, it's not where God wants such a person to be. Then he will try to displace the person and place him appropriately where he wants. So one of those things the love of God does for us is to take us from the kingdom of darkness into his light. And by an angel, there are some of us that are still where God doesn't want us to be. He is still willing and able to place us in his way. But it is a function of our response to his call. John 3:16 says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. That whosoever believes in him should not perish but have everlasting life. So those who will enjoy the love of God are those who respond to his call. God is meant for the whole world. It is conditional. Only those who will respond will enjoy it. The Lord will make us, born, will help us to continue to enjoy it in the name of Jesus.
And
the thought is that God's Lord promises to build all the broken pieces of believers. In their lives. So what are those things that have been scattered in our lives? What are those things that have been broken? Where are we experiencing shatteredness? Through the love of God, our lives can be rebuilt. He said it in his word. He says, I will rebuild. Now, verse 4. I will build you up again. And you, virgin Israel, will be rebuilt. Again, you will take your tambourine. It is the word of God, is the one promising to rebuild. And so whatever might have been experiencing destruction in our lives, tonight by the power of the Lord, the Lord will rebuild in the name of Jesus. The Lord will rebuild in the name of Jesus. And God's love promises to build up the broken pieces of believers' lives. And 41 verse 10 corroborates this. Isaiah 41 verse 10. Shall we read? Isaiah 41 10.
Isaiah, ori kokan leni ogoji ese ikewa
says,
Kabayi,
so do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be deceived, for I am your God. I will strengthen you.
That
is what I say here.
He
said, I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. This is the word of the Lord. And it will be accomplished in our lives in Jesus' name.
2
Corinthians chapter 12, verse 9.
It
says, my grace is sufficient for you. Amen. For my power is made perfect in your weakness. For where you are also experiencing weakness, God is able to strengthen you. And it doesn't matter how you have been experiencing weakness in time past. What has been happening or physically? This year, the Lord will strengthen you in the name of Jesus. The Lord will strengthen us in the name of Jesus. And he also promises restoration. God's Lord assures believers of divine restoration. Amen.
Amen.
Deuteronomy chapter 30.
Deuteronomy, O your man.
Verses 2 and 3.
Israelites.
that he will restore us again. And so for everything that has been misplaced in our lives, as we operate under the love of Christ this year, there shall be divine restoration in the name of Jesus. There shall be divine restoration in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
And he also promised us continual display of his love.
Bẹ́ẹ̀ ló ṣe ìlérí ìtànkálẹ̀ àti àfihàn lọ́nà gbangba ìfẹ́ rẹ̀ síwájú sí ikú wa.
But as long as we continue to love him,
wípé bí a ṣe ń pinnu dáńpẹ̀ àti máa rìn pẹ̀lú rẹ̀,
we will enjoy his love.
A ó máa jáde ìfẹ́ rẹ̀.
And so we need to consider further provisions of his love.
Nítorí náà a ní láti ṣe àgbéyẹ̀wò abala ìgbéra nípa ìfẹ́ rẹ̀.
Verse 4.
Ẹsẹ̀ ìgbẹ́rin.
Since I lift up in him.
Ó sọ pé ó dùn kọ́.
And you, making Israel.
Bẹ́ẹ̀ ni mo dá Israẹli.
With the rebukes.
Ó di àbúkọ́.
Again, you will take up your tambourine.
Lẹ́ẹ̀kan sọ mú èlò orin rẹ.
And go out to dance with joyful.
Ó sì jáde láti jó pẹ̀lú àwọn aláyọ̀.
Again, you will plant vineyards. On the hills of Samaria, the farmers will plant them and enjoy their fruits. And there will be a day when watchmen cry out on the hills of
Ephraim,
come on, let us go up to Zion, to the Lord our God. So notwithstanding how much or how long believers have been enjoying God's love, and we in particular, we still stand the chance to continue to enjoy it further as long as we remain in his love. God said through prophet Jeremiah that as a result of the restoration, believers will sing for joy. We will sing for joy this year in the name of Jesus. Bible says in Psalm 126 verse 5, those who sow in tears, they shall reap in joy. Where have you been sowing in tears? Where have you been experiencing bitterness? This year, joy shall be a portion in the name of Jesus. And since they will no longer labor in vain, they will enjoy the fruit of their labor. So, shall it be in the name of Jesus. You see, Isaiah chapter 65, verse 21 states, it says, they will build houses and live in them. They will find vineyards and eat their fruits. It means that we will not labor in vain. So shall it be for us in the name of Jesus. And they will work God. They will worship God and enjoy all of his wonderful deeds. Exodus chapter 23, verse 25 states, if you worship the Lord, if you serve the Lord your God,
he will
bless your food and your water. He will take away sicknesses from your midst. So when prophet Jeremiah says they will continue to worship the Lord and they will continue to enjoy his wonderful deeds, it means that as we continue to do so, then we continue to enjoy his blessings. Therefore, God's love has been made available to us, to everyone that will come under his banner. The love is inexhaustible. It is everlasting. But it can only be enjoyed by the believers in Christ. So the question tonight is, are you loved by the Lord? And have you been rightly positioned to continue to enjoy His covenant of love? Shall we rise to pray? Say, Lord, I am grateful unto you because you are a loving Father. Thank Him for being a loving Father. That even when our life did not deserve His love, He deliberately sent His only and one and begotten Son to die for us, even in our wretched state. It is the function of His love. Say, Father, we are grateful. We are grateful for this. Blessed be your name, O God. In Jesus' name we give thanks. For you to thank God for offering the greatest love, the greatest love that mankind can enjoy. That is what God has bestowed on us. Everlasting love. So say, Father, I thank you for the everlasting love you bestowed upon me. Through the birth and death of your one and only Son, Jesus Christ, express your gratitude unto Him. Let me express your gratitude unto Him. It takes someone who expresses gratitude for what he has enjoyed to receive more. Say, Lord, I am grateful unto you for your love and for the offering of your one and only Son to die in my place, to redeem me from the consequences of sin. Blessed be your name, O Lord. In Jesus' name, I pray. And so we're going to tap into the word of God tonight and keep the promises He has told us. So we repeat that. Oh Lord, I keep the divine promises inherent in your love. Amen.
We're
not responding.
Oh Lord,
I keep the divine promises inherent in your love. Praise in the name of Jesus. Those promises God has made through His love for us. Say, Lord, I receive them. I receive them in the mighty name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Jeremiah 31 verse 4 says, I will build you up again, and you, virgin Israel, will be rebuilt. That is one of the promises of God. Say, Lord, I come into your promise. I claim that promise tonight. Where my life has been shattered,
my life,
my life,
my life, tuka ni.
Is this your home that has been destroyed?
Ẹ ló ti bàjẹ́ bí.
Is this your health?
Ṣé ìlera rẹ?
God says I will rebuild it.
Olúwa sọ wípé wọ́n ó tó ká.
Thank God I tap into this promise.
Ó ti olúwa ṣe àmúlò
yìí. I receive the rebuilding.
Ó gbà tó bá náà.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Olúwa Jésù alágbára.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Olúwa Jésù alágbára.
My life is rebuilt.
Àṣẹ mi dà tó bá.
My home is rebuilt.
Ilé mi dà tó bá.
My health is rebuilt.
Ìlera mi dà tó bá.
My soul is rebuilt.
Lord, rebuild my life. You have promised.
Baba,
you have promised it, our God. You are not the man that will lie. You say you will rebuild our lives. Baba, we have been experiencing destruction. Oh Lord, by the power of your God. Rebuild our lives in Jesus' mighty name. We pray in Jesus' name. We are
praying.
Jeremiah 31 verse 4.
He
says, again, you will take up your tambourine and go out to dance with the jockey for
you.
We say, Lord Jesus, by the power of your love, cause my joy to be full in you. This year, cause my joy to be full in you. Prayers in the name of Jesus. in Jesus.
My name will pray.
No, Jesus.
He said, Lord Jesus,
I
was not experiencing sorrow this year. My family was not experiencing sorrow this year. Everything in the world of sorrow. Or plant vineyard and others eat. So the day of the king. So will the days of my people. My chosen ones will enjoy long. Will long enjoy the war of their days. This year, Lord, help me to enjoy the work of my hands. Help me that I will not walk like anyone and beat my hands.
Prayers in the name of Jesus.
That with the faithful efforts will help me to put in place this year.
And enjoy bountiful harvest.
For my sake,
rebuke
every devourer this year. Open my job and businesses. Open my endeavors. Rebuke devourers for my sake this year. Pray in the name of Jesus. Lord, rebuke every devourer. Rebuke every devourer. Rebuke every devourer. Spiritually or physically. Rebuke every devourer for my sake. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Jonas chapter 2, verse 25. The scripture says, I will repay you for the years the locusts have eaten. The great locust and the young locust. The other locust and the locust swarm. Amen. So it doesn't matter what has been causing wastage in your effort all along. It doesn't matter the kind of that has been affecting your life. What the Lord is saying is that He will repay you. Where you have experienced losses in the years past, or where you have even experienced loss in these few days we have spent in a year, God says He will repay you. He will compensate you. That is by His love. Claim it. God, according to your work, repay me for these years I have lost. Repay me for the workers I have lost. On the hills of Ephraim,
lórí òkè Éfraimu.
Come, let us go up to Zion.
Ẹ wá o ẹsọ̀ ẹ̀dìkẹ́ kí ẹjẹ́ kí a lọ sí Ẹ́fẹ́sìọ́nì.
To the Lord our God.
Sí Olúwa Ọlọ́run wa.
Zion is a place of encounter with God.
Sí ó lè jẹ́ ibi ìbápàdépọ̀ pẹ̀lú Ọlọ́run.
Zion is a place of worship of our God.
Sí ó lè jẹ́ ibi ìjọsìn fún Ọlọ́run wa.
So we need to pray.
Nítorí náà ó gbàdúrà.
God,
Ọlọ́run,
grace to serve you and to worship you faithfully this year.
Orí ọ̀dọ́ àti ṣiṣẹ́ fún yín àti láti ṣe nínú ọdún yìí lóṣù tó àti lódodo.
Bestow upon me and my household.
Pàpẹ́ ìdáhùn mi lórí àti ìdílé mi.
Bestow upon your child.
Ìdáhùn ìtọ́jú lórí.
Grace to worship and serve you faithfully this year.
Orí ọ̀dọ́ àti ṣe fún yín.
We need to worship in the name of Jesus. Let's begin to thank God for answer prayers. Because more than we have all opposing tonight, the Lord will answer us. And testimonies have followed this encounter. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we are praying.
Yeah.
And so our greatest God, Father, we thank you. For the opportunity to raise our voices unto you tonight. And Lord, we ask that more than we have cried unto you. Tonight we answer us in the name of Jesus.
And
testimony will follow this encounter. Blessed be your name, O God. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.